everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. It's hard to imagine this not being a fun game to watch. It's the Browns going up against the Redskins.
We are just inside the Beltway, about 10 miles east of the Capitol Dome, as we come to you from FedEx Field here in Landover. Today, it's week four, and we've got what should be a great one here between the Cleveland Browns and the Washington Redskins. To the 27, give him 4 yards. Sam Acho there for the stop. See if they stay on the ground for second down. Mariota now on second down, and he's got his man on the out route, and he's brought down after a good game. That one goes for 24 yards. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
But that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
This is Howard on second down. Trying to run inside, but nothing there. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. And Charles, we get a look here at the key. And I tell you what, a big list for being this early in the season.
If there's any silver lining at all, you're hoping you can get these guys back, and now you'll play well down the stretch with them. But what you're also hoping is that the guys who have to play for them, the next man up mentality kicks in, and those guys take care of business.
Now Justin Tucker. He has hit from 61 in his career, so he has the leg for this. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So the folks here in the stands this afternoon, they're happy about that one. Their guys get the early advantage after the opening drive field goal.
And they should be happy. Their guys look good getting down the field, and that's got to give them hope that good things are in store here today.
Defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. They tried to run the counter, just that the defense wasn't fooled.
And when they're not fooled, you see the end result, because what you're doing there, you...
And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. The four-time All-Pro, Navarro Bowman, in there to bring him down for a loss of 7.
Okay, you know my bias is about to come out here. A lot of people think that the offense is just moving in the wrong direction. I'd say they're moving in the right direction because the defense is pushing them back.
Former defensive guy. Now, as a quarterback, third and long, you really got to rally the troops here, don't you?
Yeah, you're doing a big way, and what else do you have to look out for? More pressure coming at you because it seems to be working pretty well.
Now the rookie from Syracuse, Riley Dixon, to punt. Back deep, J.J. Nelson. This is fielded at the 27. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Redskins will take possession with Washington as they come onto the field. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put 6 on the board here. We'll see. And it's a short one here, complete to the tight end. He got 29 yards that time.
coach is always harp on, the quarterback reading the defense and getting it to the open man. That's good recognition there. And how about what he did after the catch?
Yeah, hit your tight end, let him get some rack.
Yeah, when he gets moving, not many guys want to come over and put a hit on him, do they?
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and two. And the next snap coming inside the red zone here.
This drive is turning into an extended one, and the guy carrying the ball, he's becoming more like a body blows guy. Every carry is putting some damage on the defense. So after a while, I'm not too sure how many guys are going to want to run up and tackle him.
And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff.
Yeah, when we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time. Really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on. All right, partner, despite my eating habits, I'm not big enough to play offensive tackle, nor am I quick enough. But with the defensive ends nowadays and their speed, those guys have to be able to punch and dance, and it's a tough, tough job to contain them.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number 2. They're on the march, but facing a third down here. On third down, Mariota. Now they set up the screen. That's complete. And the screen only good for 3 that time, and it'll bring up a fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the left hash, a chip shot here.
They dialed up the screen pass on third down, and for a second it looked like it was all going to come together. They had a chance to pick up a first down, but the defense got there and finished it off.
So that scores now in their first 2 possessions, but it's 6-0, probably not the kind of scores they were hoping for.
No, not at all, but I think that they've shown that they can have some success against this defense. So they go back to the sideline knowing the points are going to be there for the taking.
And now Cleveland geared up to take the field. And they'll certainly be trying to do better than that first drive where they went 3 and out.
And sometimes the first drive is just simply to settle nerves. You know what it's like at the start of a game with the emotion. Guys are a little bit jumpy.
Oh, you do.
Oh, you understand the same way. Just like a...
And Redskins lost the football. And the Redskins scoop it. And he gets it back into the end zone. It's a fumble recovery leading to a Washington touchdown. Fumble return for a TD by the Redskins. Last year, they recovered 16 of them, most in the NFL, on their way to that NFC East title.
The word that comes to mind immediately is opportunistic. This is a defense that knew how to make plays and capitalize on them.
And he's got it to make it now 13-0. And you can bet they're preaching 2 hands on the ball here as the kick's away following that fumble return. That's fielded in the end zone. And this will be a touchback. Last year would have come out to the 20. This year they'll move it out to the 25-yard line. And here are the Browns now as the offense comes back out onto the field. Now a play fake here on first down. And he was hit as he threw it there, and it forces it incomplete.
It's a tried-and-true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. Here's Winston. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down. Offense trying to avoid stalling out, facing a 3rd and 10. And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. 6 DBs in the game.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do.
And the pressure gets there, and Winston goes down. Willie Young able to track him down for a loss of 13. And it'll bring up 4th down. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done. First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking. But the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one good for 16, and the drive will continue. So the offense has it first and 10.
That was a nice completion on an out route. And those types of plays are the result of arm strength by the quarterback and timing by the receiver.
Out to the left, it's complete to Dixon. The completion good for 3, and it's second down. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his. And this is one of those plays that if you can use it to keep the chains moving, it's a good play. And not only that, it tends to tamp down the pass rushers because they have to recognize this play and stay at home. The quarterback uses it well. Read option, keeps it, and picks up a first down with some nice running. Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.
It's a good gain of 11, sets him up first and goal. Well, the coaches mentioned they weren't as concerned about big play offense. They thought they could get some shorter, quicker stuff and be consistent. And that's kind of what they showed there.
What they saw in preparation, what they saw in film, is a defense that likes to get out fast in terms of coverage, meaning they either bail out or they give them a lot of space to throw the underneath stuff, so they decide they take advantage of it and worked on it hard in practice this week.
It's a 5-receiver set, 3 to the left, 2 to the right. Looks like the defense in press coverage here. Second down, Mariota. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
The good signal call is we never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
Dancing to his left. He can run for it, and he will. He'll wind up being stopped for no gain, and it'll lead to a fourth down. 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Back to FedEx Field following this short break. Back now. As I search for my cue card here, there we go. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Redskins. Their big tight end with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Redskins are going to add on to their... And that one pushes the lead up to an even 20. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now the Browns offense trots back onto the field. And still no points on the scoreboard. You're coming off of the 3-and-out. They're just looking for anything to grab onto right now, aren't they?
I'm wondering if someone's going to take charge in the huddle. You know, we always look to the quarterback, but sometimes it's another player on the team, a star, a veteran, someone with some excitement and energy. It's like, all right, guys, let's shake things up and let's go, because they still have an opportunity to make things happen.
Shake it off. Finding time. Still back there. He's going to float this one deep right side. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third.
On every offensive coordinator, every play caller sheet, they have about five or six plays per game that they call shot plays or big plays. And you don't get many opportunities to dial them up. And they just did. And they dropped it with a great chance to make a big play. That's going to hurt. When a good play is made on defense, oftentimes leverage is the key to everything. Defensive line not getting turned, all the other guys making sure they're in the right spot. And on that play, they were able to stop them short of a first down.
And it's taken in at the nine. He had one man to beat. It takes a touchdown saving tackle to bring him down. And the Redskins will have a short field here as they take over first and 10. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
Now a second down throw for Mariota. And that is incomplete. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. It looks like a nickel set now for the Browns on third down. They'll try to run for it with Howard. And he will have a first down at about the 21-yard line. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. They go play action here on first down. And he finds a man on the crossing route. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. To throw Mariota. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. Give him seven on the play, and that'll bring up a second and goal. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
Mariota. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
All defenders get tired of hearing about their lack of hands and why they're playing defense instead of offense. But in this situation, it was the hands that made the play. Batting the ball away on an attempted touchdown pass, excellent job. Way to knock it down.
Now third down and goal from the one. And this is going to result in losing yardage. They're driven back to the 8-yard line. And welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout. And now they get set to line up as we resume action. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And that lead will move from 20 up now to 23. So that one is his third of the game. Now, if you're wondering, that's only halfway to his career high as he once had six field goals.
Brandon, six? Let's hope we don't get that again, please. Okay, can we see a few touchdowns here and there?
That'd be nice. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we send you down to Orlando. Hey, Charles, can you give me a water? Jeez, Chuck, they cut off the halftime show again. Quicker than anticipated, ready for the start of the second half. That'll be taken in the end zone. Yeah, some might have returned that one. He won't. He'll go down to a knee, and they'll start the drive from the 25. Here's the Browns offense now getting set to start off this third quarter. They come up in an offset eye. They come out here with a zero on the scoreboard. What was said in that locker room? That's what I want to know.
I would love to have been in there because we often have the feeling that there's a lot of shouting, screaming, people upset. But typically, halftime locker rooms are a lot more clinical than that. And in this case, are they upset that the plays weren't working because of execution? Or did they think just they were just bad plays to call?
Yeah.
We'll find out pretty quickly here if they felt like they had something going, but they just need to do it a little bit better or not.
We'll find out.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play calling. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it, but you try and give it a little bit of help.
Yeah, that right there will set him back a bit on the offensive holding penalty.
And you know who you want to pressure after a penalty like that? The guy who just committed the foul. You want to see if he's going to keep his head down or if he's going to get his head right back into the game. I'd send the blitz at him right away and see if he holds up.
And he'll be about a full yard shy of the 20 at the 19-yard line. Here's Riley Dixon now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
This is brought in at the 21. Might have been one man away from 6 points. As it stands, it's a huge return. And this offense is going to be set up with a first and 10 inside the 15. So now we look at the Redskins offense getting ready for their first possession of the second half. They have the lead here. Well, we talk a lot about pregame speeches. What are halftime speeches like?
For the most part, not nearly as emotional. They're a lot more clinical. Every now and then, though, they'll get after you if they think they need to light a fire. But in this case, let's go into the virtual locker room, because here's what I think happened. They got in there and they said, listen, let's take control right away. Defense, we got the lead. Defense, don't give up any points. Turn the ball back over to the offense and let them go down and score and give us more of a cushion in the game. Check so far. Defense shut them down. Let's see if the offense gets done.
Mariota from the gun on third down. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. So he makes the grab and the chains move forward.
Nice job by the offensive line, giving them time to complete that first down pass.
They go play action. Mariota. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
When defenses get to the quarterback that quickly, a lot of times it's called a jailbreak. It wasn't quite that fast, but fast enough that he had no time to look downfield and set himself to throw the ball. And as he tried to do that, he was hit and it forced an incompletion.
Mariota again. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. Third and goal, Mariota. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
So making 4 out of 4 now in the field goal department, and he's able to extend their lead.
When drives have bogged down, he's been automatic out there. So nice to have a kicker you can count on to put points on the board.
This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And the Browns getting set to go. And 3 and out on the last drive. No points on the scoreboard. A little soul-searching now?
I would say so, and they need to help out their defense a little bit. They've got to be on the field a lot more than normal, put them in some tough spots. But what's the old adage? When you get another chance, it gives you a better chance to do it right.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down.
Well, the pressure, the hits, the sacks have been coming at them all game long. I'm frankly surprised that they haven't found a solution yet to create more time for them to throw it, or maybe change what they do on offense.
And yeah, that's one of the biggest differences in this game and why they're losing right now.
And that run was what a lot of people call an explosive run. Gave them good yardage, solid yardage. They feel good about the whole thing, and they did it behind a 2 tight end set. It's always interesting to watch what offenses want to do with the 2 tight ends. Sometimes they line them up together for a power set. Sometimes they put one on each side of the line of scrimmage to balance things out. No matter what, though, when you see 2 tight ends on the field, your first thought is to think run. In this case, the offense is able to run successfully.
First down. Here's the run with Martin. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
Tough day. Tough sledding right there, and it's been that way the entire game. Not a whole lot of room to ramble for him.
Yeah, you're right. It's been that way all afternoon. Didn't get a whole lot better there. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
So now the Browns will turn it over to their field goal unit here. This from 54 yards away. And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And the drive will wind up yielding 3. It's really something. Even when he's hitting these from distance, big time distance, he manages to put them right down the middle, doesn't he?
No doubt about that one. Never a doubt. And this is no extra point. That's 50 plus. And that's the definition of splitting the uprights. Any return that gets you to midfield is a great return. One first down, and you're almost in field goal position.
The Browns defense getting ready. And they did well down near the goal line last time, forcing him to settle for a short field goal.
And in today's day and age, settling for a field goal of that distance is amazing. You can get 3 points now, where it's going to give you only 1 point for the extra point, which will be a little bit longer. But it'll have to feel fantastic not only giving up 3 in that situation. It could have been so much worse.
Yeah, it could have. Now can they carry that over?
Well, plenty of credit has to go to the guy carrying the ball and broke the tackle and gained the yardage. But that doesn't necessarily mean that the defender's bad. They're not going to make 100% of the tackles all the time. Even the best in the game will miss one occasionally. The key is not to let it snowball and miss tackle after tackle. On that play, credit to the offense, but that doesn't make the defense bad.
So it's a quarter that saw these two teams trade field goals here as we've reached the end of 3 quarters of play. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now at FedEx Field. A lot of happy faces in the crowd at this point as their guys have a big lead here to start quarter number 4. Offense comes to the line now, 1st and 10. First down, Mariota. This will be caught just inside the 10. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now 1st and goal.
Well, coaches always talk about finding balance on offense. How do you get much more balance than this? Big-time run, big-time pass.
A 1-2 combination. Looked pretty good.
How about that? Let's see if they can continue to take that kind of a punch, though.
Mario fighting for the end zone. He lost the football. It's out. The big man, get the oxygen tank ready. A little track jump. He's at the 40. And a huge return as he'll take this one all the way down inside the 30-yard line.
Well, maybe it hasn't exactly been a Rembrandt, but they've been mistake-free to this point and finally cough it up. I don't think it's going to cost them the game. They should be fine. But, boy, they're going to hate that, going back and watching tape and being able to say we were that close to achieving our goal of 0 turnovers during the game.
A little blemish, but as you say, still comfortably in command. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag, be careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
On 2nd down, Martin. And he's got some space here. And he'll take it into the end zone for a Browns touchdown. Doug Martin, his 4th touchdown on the year. And the Browns take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash this one in.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit. But for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
J.J. Nelson now to return. And his guys are going to start their drive right at the 20-yard line. The Redskins offense now, they get set to take over here. And they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that, because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field. And to come away with nothing, that's difficult for a team to handle.
And difficult, and now we'll see if they can make it less difficult on themselves on this drive. Escaping the pressure right. Now he's good. Oh, this is taken in. It's complete. Past the 20. Touchdown, Washington. Paul Richardson, 77 yards. And the Redskins find a way to stretch their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
And the lead opens up now to 22 points. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Heading out is the Cleveland offense now as they get set to take over here. And they're going to need another score. Got one last time, but still down here.
When you're playing catch-up, every possession becomes crucial, doesn't it? It's vital. Get back out on the field, punch in the end zone again. They know it's not easy, but what they do have going for them, they did score the last time. They think they've got a good formula working.
And what about the defense?
Well, now you're just saying to yourself, okay, give up a score last time. What adjustments do we need to make to slow them down now and get the ball back for our own offense? Is it more pressure? Is it more zone? What do they have to do? They're trying to figure that out themselves.
We'll see if they can figure that out right here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Fresh set of downs here.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Winston now to throw on first down. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll make this a second down.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense, be aware a ball may come your way.
Again, it's Winston. Right side catch. This is Gates. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. And the offense lining up first and 10.
There's a completion to the tight end, and I think that we're looking at something out of central casting, frankly.
Absolutely.
I mean,
size, the hands.
Speed. I mean, can flat out run. You put that whole package together, you light up the eyes of an offensive coordinator, don't you?
A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
It's a loss of 5 there, bringing up second. One receiver to the left is Cooper. They'll throw again. Winston goes underneath to Martin. And they'll get this one down to about the 20-yard line. They pick up 12 on the play there, and they move the chains. One man on the backfield, that's Martin. Time for a break. This one all over but the shouting. We'll finish it after this. So the Browns in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. The first down throw for Winston. And Bryant's got it over the middle. And they've got it inside the 10 at the 8. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal. And now they're in the hurry up. Jameis to throw it. And incomplete. He dropped it in the end zone. He was looking for Antonio Gates that time. And it's second down. Now this will be the 9th play on this drive.
Just looking at it from a defensive perspective, when you break the huddle in the red zone, tight end is one of the guys you've got a key on, because quarterbacks want the ball in their hands fast in this position, and they want to get it to someone. And in this case, he had the play. They just didn't complete it.
They got to have 6 here. It's 3rd and goal. Winston into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the longtime Charger, Eric Weddle. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Well, this defensive pressure has been constant all game long. The pass rush, the coverage, they've all been excellent, and now they'll tack on an interception here as this one continues to slip just further and further out of hand.
Running with Howard. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
That first down play, all you want to do is wedge out any type of space and try and create enough room. If you have to run the punter out there, he can successfully complete the punt.
Yeah, didn't get a ton there, but at least some positive yardage. Give him 11 yards that time and a new set of downs.
Well, I'd say that run's pretty emblematic of what we've seen all day long. No matter what they've done on offense, this offensive line has controlled the line of scrimmage, giving them time to throw it, run it, do whatever they wanted. That's why there are points up on the board. And right now,
and I think the ball's out, but this will fortunately wind up out of bounds.
And I have to admit, partner, that I've often thought that I don't like this rule where the offensive player fumbles the ball, it goes out of bounds, and they get to keep it.
That's just because you're a defensive guy. That's why you don't like it.
Yeah, you're right. It is a slanted view, isn't it?
But this is where, for the offensive team, the sideline is their friend. Usually it's not their friend.
Yeah, exactly right. I actually played for a guy in college. You know what he used to name the sideline? Sammy. Sammy sideline, and use him well.
Now they try the right side here. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he's into the clear. The 20. Touchdown, Washington. A great play there. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Redskins are going to add on to their lead.
And to me, that touchdown allows you to start grinning widely on your sideline. I think they pretty much locked this one away.
Yeah, that's the clincher, the proverbial icing on the cake, if you will. Tucker now for the extra point. And that'll push the lead up to 29 now. So that drive spanned 5 plays. And the result, a touchdown for Washington. Tucker now to kick it away following the touchdown. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And now the Browns coming out on the field. They're down big here late. I don't know. You just one last drive here for pride.
Some people like to do that. I remember playing for a guy once. We were down huge, and someone said, "Coach, what do you want to call?"
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Now Jameis on 2nd down, surveying the field. And he slides. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. So here we go, 1st and 10 now. 1 receiver to the left is Cooper.
Ready, blue lady. 53 is the mic. 53 is the mic.
1st down, Winston. He's got time in the pocket. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. And this looks to probably be the... And now we're going to get a timeout called by the Redskin defense. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines... A One last shot now for Winston. He's got time. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for Washington, it'll be a .500 start as the win gets them back to 2-2. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Baltimore Ravens. Meanwhile, for Cleveland, the defeat is their first of the year as they drop to 3-1. And they'll try again next week at home against New England. So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. It's a win for the Redskins as we say so long from FedEx Field.